Before we move on to the last steps of testing our model, let's talk a little bit about Django Admin Site. The Django Admin Site is a feature that is built into Django whenever we utilize the Django framework. It's a really handy tool which allows us to interact with our database tables. By default, it is active, so we can get straight into the admin panel. The only step that we need to take to access the admin panel is to create a new user. So let's do that first. Close the server if it's on, and let's go ahead and use the manage.py and create super user. So this is going to create a super user. Now, obviously, a super user is an admin user. So typically, we want to make sure that that is obviously secure, but because this is in development, we're just going to use a very simple, easy, rememberable username and password. So I'm going to add admin as the username. There is no need to type in an email address. I'm just going to press enter. And then the password, I'm going to type in admin. You won't be able to see it. It will be hidden, but I'm actually typing it in. It'll be the same on yours. So if you can't see anything, it is secure. So no one else can see what you're typing in, but you are typing something in. So admin, and then press Y to agree to the fact that that password isn't very good. And there we go. So now we've created a new admin user. Let's go ahead and start the server. Now, if you're wondering where to access the server, remember we've got our 127.0.0.1 loopback address here that we need to type into the URL. But if you go into the URLs of our application, you can see that there is one URL already, and that's the admin URL. So this is the path. This is what Django is looking for in order to take us to the admin site. So we need to type in 127.0.0.1:8000/ and then admin/, or just admin. So back in the browser, let's go ahead and I'll type that in 127.0.0.1, and then admin. And there we go. So that's the Django admin. So we should be able to log in with admin and admin now. Not now. And there we go. So that's the Django administration. So by default, you can see that there's two areas here, or two models essentially, that we can interact with, users and groups. So I can go ahead and add a new user. We can see the user that we have already created. So because we created our own model, we are going to need to register our model to the Django admin site here. So let's go back into our code. You can see that in the blog app here, we're provided by default the admin.py file. So that's what Django is going to look for any changes to make in the admin site. So here, all that we need to do is just add our model. So let's go ahead and say from.models. We need to import our model. From.models, let's import our model called blog. Okay. Admin models. Okay. It was called blog, wasn't it? Oh, post. That's why. I was wondering why it wasn't coming up. There we go, post. Okay, so we'll detect. And now we just need to register it. So that's just going to be a case of, in the simplest case, of course, admin.site.register, and then post. Okay, so that should register our new table. If we go back now and refresh the admin site, it should be instance. And there we go. So we now have the post table in our blog app here. So let's take a look. We can add a new post, and now we can go ahead and add some new data into our database. So let's make sure it's published, press save, and you can see that there is an error. So it says post object has no attribute name. Okay, so we made a mistake earlier in the code, which was handy because we tend to learn more when there's a mistake. And I wanted to show you this specifically. So it helped me remind myself that I wanted to emphasize this point, this dunder string return here. So I'm just going to remove it to begin with and press save. Okay, so I've removed the dunder string method in our models in our blog app. And this gives us a chance to explain what it does. So I'm just going to refresh again. Just press send. Send. There we go. So you can see that we've created now a new post. Now, if you didn't do that, just create a new post. And you can see it says post object one. So that doesn't really give me much information about my object. This is related to an object or to a row in our database, of course, this individual post. So it doesn't really give me much information. So the dunder string method, this is going to give us an opportunity for us to actually provide a human readable name for that particular object. So I change the DunderString method to title and then press save. And then if I go back and refresh, you can now see it says the name, or the title, sorry, of the post. And that just makes it easier for me to identify that particular object. Hey, maybe I need to edit that so I can find it, I can search for it. If I wanted to, I could create some search facilities here, go into it, make some changes. Now, of course, the admin site, there's many, many different changes we can make here. That isn't something that we need to concentrate on at this point because we have all the tools that we need right now. We just need to be able to create some new data. We can inspect it before we leave. Let's go into our database here. Let's go and open it up in SQLite. So what we can do is there's a refresh button here and click on that. Let's go back in. So what I can now do is go onto my table, right click, show table, and you can now see the data inside of a table, directly in the table. So you can see that there are some additional information here that you don't see in the admin. Created at, updated at, if you remember, and also the foreign key. So here it links over to the user that has created the post, as well as the primary key here on the left-hand side.